Hello friends, welcome to all of you in Dr. Jaggi's Academy. Today I will discuss the two important terms related to the atom. That is, the number one is atomic number and second one is the mass number. So let's start. So first I will start with the atomic number. So as we know that we have a different element, some of the elements are natural and some of the elements are synthetic. So each element is different from one another by a number, and that number is known as atomic number. It means we can say that each element has this particular atomic number. No two elements have a same atomic number. Each element has its own atomic number. So I have discussed earlier in my previous video, that is, the atom is made up of three particles. Number one is electron, second one is proton, and third one is neutron. The negatively charged particle is known as electron, positively charged particle is known as proton, and the neutral particle is known as, that is, neutron. So in an atom, the number of electron is equal to the number of proton, because atom is a neutral. Due to electron, that atom carries negative charge, and due to proton, atom carries positive charge. So in an atom is neutral. It means the number of net positive charge is equal to net negative charge. So that I discussed in my previous lecture. So atomic number means the number of electron is equal to number of proton. So that is term is atomic number. So what is importance of atomic number? Actually, atomic number helps to calculate the number of electron and proton in an atom. If you know the atomic number, you can easily calculate the how many number of electron and proton they are present in a particular atom. So I will explain by taking the example. So first example is hydrogen, whose atomic number is 1. So to calculate the number of electron and proton in hydrogen atom, it means atomic number is 1. It means the number of electron is equal to 1 and number of proton is also 1, because atomic number is equal to the number of electron equal to number of proton. It means the atomic number is equal to number of electrons or protons. So this is this I will explain by taking the example of hydrogen. The second example is oxygen, whose atomic number is 8. So it means how many number of electrons and protons in an oxygen atom. So in this case, again, atom number of electron is 8 and number of proton is also equal to 8, since atomic number is equal to number of electrons and number of proton. The third example is carbon, whose atomic number is 6. It means the number of electron is equal to 6 and number of proton is also equal to 6. So this is an atomic number, and it helps to calculate the number of electron and proton in an atom. The next one is mass number. So it is also an important characteristic feature of an atom. And what is the mass number? Actually, the mass number is equal to the number of protons plus number of neutrons. So if we sum the protons and neutrons in an atom, that is equal to its mass number. So what is significance? What is the importance of mass number? Actually, mass number helps to calculate the number of neutrons in an atom. If we know the mass number of a particular atom, you can easily calculate the how many number of neutrons are present in that atom. So we have a mass number is equal to number of proton plus number of neutron. So if you want to calculate the number of neutron, then number of neutron is equal to the mass number minus number of protons. Clear? The next one is, though this is explained, how will you calculate the number of neutrons from the mass number? So it will, I will explain by taking an example of different elements or different atom. So here we have an oxygen atom whose atomic number is 8 but mass number is 60. So how will you calculate the total number of electron, proton and neutron in an oxygen atom? So this is, as we know that atomic number is equal to number of electron equal to number of proton. So in this case atomic number is 8. It means the number of electron is equal to 8 and number of proton is equal to 8. So from atomic number we calculate the number of electrons and proton present in an oxygen atom. So next step is how will you calculate the number of neutron, and that is calculated from the mass number. So how will you calculate the mass number of neutron from mass number? So since as we know that the mass number is equal to number of protons plus number of neutron, then the number of neutron is equal to mass number minus number of protons. So as we know that the mass number is 16 and number of proton is 8. So 16 minus 8, it means number of neutrons present in an oxygen atom is 8. So therefore from atomic number and Y we can easily calculate the number of electron, protons and neutron. The next example is carbon whose atomic number is 6. However, the mass number is 12. So we can easily calculate the number of electron, proton and neutron in a carbon atom. From atomic number we calculate the number of electron and protons. Since atomic number of the carbon is 6, it means number of electron is 6 and number of proton is also 6. And the number of neutron is calculated from the mass number. Number of neutrons, they are calculated from the mass number. So number of neutron is equal to mass number minus number of protons. So since the mass number is 12 carbon, so number of proton is 6. So 12 minus 6 is 6. So in this way we can, from mass number and atomic number, we calculate the number of electrons, protons and neutrons. So in my upcoming video I will discuss the different theories of the atom that shows that explain the arrangement of particles within atom. So first of all I will discuss the Bohr theory of atom. Thank you.